We're just noticing that there's no alignment adjusters on this car except for the tow rod. So, nothing about camber. Can't mess with anything except for the tow. So, we're just gonna put a paint pin right there on this guy so we can start taking stuff apart and still achieve the same alignment when we put it back together. So Chris is noticing this weird feature on the rotor. I thought it was just some shape for cooling, but Chris pointed out that there's actually like a gap there. Like it's a multi-piece rotor. I guess we'll find out when we take it off the car. But is that a feature that makes it a floating rotor? So with the transmission jack underneath the rear lower control arm, and then all the bolts taken out one by one. And the final bolt is just gonna be the inboard one, and we can drop the spring. Oh yeah, nice. Ready for it? We thought that the rear shock was gonna be the thing that was holding up the rear suspension when the spring's out. But right now we've got a little slack in the brake line. And I think what's actually holding it up is just the tension of these rubber bushings and these arms just being like maxed out. Yeah, we used an E18 giant torx bit to get the caliper off, put the car in towing transport mode, and then zip tied the caliper up. 32mm. On the impact for the main axle nut. Look at these captured Nordlock washers on that main axle nut. So the dead blow didn't work on taking the axle out, so we got the sledge, and then we just put a piece of aluminum up there and knocked it in. So what's the trick on the wheel speed sensor?
I'm just gonna undo the cork so I don't risk tearing something that far.
Just regular Torx and the wheel speed sensor.
Looks like it.
Dude.
Wow, my hand looks so weird.
Floating rotor action. That's pretty light.
Yeah.
Is it actually too easy? Yeah. Just hold it out.
Yeah, Chris noticed that there was like a crack, kind of like around the shape on the outside, like on the spline.
Mm-hmm.
And then it turns out, yeah, it's even more obvious if you look at the inside. It's a multi-piece.
And that little tab just gets bent in.
So they just slide them together and then bend these little tabs at those points, like where it's like an arrow point. Can you feel the tension on those remaining two arms bushings? Or is it the axle that's getting maxed out too?
I think it's definitely the combination of the two upper arms, this inside joint here.
You feel the springiness on the rubber?
Yeah, as I bring it back up to ride height, then the bushing straightens itself out. And as you drop it, it goes into twist.
But we have the axle pressed in off the knuckle right now, so it's probably, you can see the accordion boot on the inside is kind of like all pressed in, so it must be maxing out as well.
Oh, I might not have seen that.
off this last upper arm off.
You need me to pop that actually if you there you go. That we just used on the wheel speed sensor. It's going to be the same for this brake plate right here.
The current problem on the upper traction arm is that you just can't get a hold of slamming it against the chassis.
Same thing, you just have to take this lower subframe brace off.
Oh, so the upper and lower traction arm has the same problem?
This one's much easier to fix. Oh, I got them pull a little bit further out than that.
So, oh, what? Like the two forks on there? You're able to kind of like spread them?
Yeah, I mean there.
So you spread the forks a little, and then you wiggle that thing out.
Yeah, and then you get a cut.
And then you can just like fiddle with the bolt until the bolt pops out? Or you just leave the bolt in there?
Okay, you get the bolt out.
Oh, okay. Oh, I got the arm out. So then you put the arm back in at that same like funky angle and then just kind of like shove them in there and then press the bolt back in?
Yeah, I mean, even dropping the subframe, you're not freeing up any space right here. And then you have this seam.
All right, so that it actually have to drop down pretty far. You couldn't just loosen the subframe bolts.
Yeah, unless you could get the whole subframe pitched. But...
Right. Okay. All right, so here's the whole collection of parts that we have scored from taking apart the rear end. Super cool two-piece rotor, very light, sheet metal center. All these straight arms and rods. Chances are, the more cars we make car parts for, the luckier we get in just having the right length adjustable straight arms. Sway bar link, hub. This is a huge rear lower control arm, but my aim is to make a true coilover, not a separated spring and shock. And then nice, lightweight rear knuckle right here. That'll definitely let us know what's happening in the rear suspension geometry when we model it up with the subframe and everything. Oh, what's that? Forged knuckles.